I got the piece of solid back in there. I'm going to cut it down to, I think, either 2.5 or 3 inches. The bearing pocket or bore will set in about 1.5 inches, or it is set in 1.5 inches. So it would go at least 2. I don't know how much. I should do the math, see how much distance I need to do a 60 degree cut on it, or bevel, or angle, or whatever. Yeah, I think I'll just do a 2.5. Unfortunately, I don't own a bandsaw to cut that down, so I'm going to have to kind of do it on here. Not really thrilled about having to do it on here. And then the chop saw I got, it's just too big of a diameter to be able to clamp it down in the chop saw. So I'm probably going to try to use I went completely brain dead. I'm going to try to use the parting tool on it. I'm not going to go all the way through it, just most of the way. And then I'll get probably just take one of my 6-inch grinder blades and just finish it off with the grinder. Mainly I don't go all the way through it, just kind of don't want all that weight to drop off. But we'll get through most of it and try to not, screw up, not damage the mill or the lathe or myself in the process.
Thank you.
got the shaft part. Part that'll go into tailstock here. I'm going to have one bearing facing this direction, and one bearing facing this direction. And then this will get turned down to a Morris taper, which this can fit through. So we'll get that turned down. Thank you. the shaft flipped around. I got in a collet. I'm gonna go ahead and turn all this down and put the Morris taper in there. First, I'm gonna put a center point so that way I can put the live center in there and keep this from moving around, just because there's not very much stuck into the collet, so this will probably start moving around on me when I go to turn it. So we'll go ahead and get that going. I remember right, I think that is 1.5 degrees on the compound. I'll have to double check that, but we'll be back when I'm set up. All right, we got her set up. Now the travel of my compound is not the full length of a normal Morris taper would be, a number 3. Morris taper, so it'll be about 1/2 inch short, and that's where it'll end, is right there. So that'll just get turned down and made into the little tang on the back end of the taper, this guy right here. So this will just be, I'll just turn that down a little bit, and then we'll put the flats, and then it'll be, it should still work just fine. So let's get to it.
Okay.